where three other teens robbed it. And Mike, this is the ironic thing. The other people who went to jail on this, who actually did the robbery, they've been out of prison for a long time. So these two sisters remained in jail all this time.
They had no priors. What, they were 21 and 19 at the time, basically kids?
Both young women, no priors, and that's what surprised everybody about this case. The jurors say they're free.
Rochelle, I know our viewers have been so invested in this story. What are folks saying is it finally takes freedom?
We are getting a lot of comments about it, and Ryan made a really good point. This story was actually on the radar of civil rights activists long before the issue of the kidney donation came up, long time before that. But let me share some comments. Shay says this, it's wrong on so many levels. Governor Barber could have just stepped in and committed their sentences or pardoned them instead. Unfortunately, this is what Shay says here in Mississippi State, those without money to hire real legal help get railroaded. So she has a problem with the fact that this seems to be, in her opinion, conditional that she has to donate the kidney to get out. Carl says, I think that their release is the proper action. They have spent nearly half of their lives in prison, and release is long overdue. And while they are not considered prisoners as of this morning, being on parole does still keep them under some type of supervision. So the questions that you and Ryan have addressed and touched on, should you have to donate a kidney to get out of prison? This raises so many ethical questions that we're going to break down for you.